is we're training ourselves to become good photographers and be able to take great pictures of any subject. We need to look at light and the effect that light has on our subjects. But equally important, along with that, is the effect that shadows have on our subjects. Shadows are going to define the shape, the depth, and the texture of our subjects. In fact, if we have a silhouette, the shadows basically are our subjects. As my friend and educational colleague Sil Arena has said, if you want interesting pictures, you need interesting shadows. So you need to start to train yourself to become aware of the effect of shadows in your pictures and what they're doing for your subjects. One of the key things that shadows do is they define what photographers call the quality of light. Now, when we talk about quality of light, this has nothing to do with how much light is in a scene. We can be out in the middle of the Arizona desert at high noon on a clear sunny day and, figuratively speaking, have all the light in the world. And many photographers would tell you that at that time of day, we don't have a good quality of light. But when we talk quality of light, what we're talking about is really what the shadows are doing for us. You'll hear photographers use terms like hard light. And when they say that, what they mean is that we have a light source similar to the sun on a clear day that's giving us very dark, sharply defined shadows. There are times when this type of lighting and these kind of shadows can really enhance certain types of subjects, especially early in the morning or late in the afternoon. They can give us a lot of depth. They can give us real texture in our subjects, in our surfaces, and really enlighten what the subject is all about. They're not, however, always the best situations to be taking photographs of people in a traditional sense, like portraits and so on. You'll hear photographers use terms like soft light. And when they're talking that, they're talking light, think of like an overcast day, where you have, instead of dark, sharp-edged shadows, you have much lighter shadows that tend to have much softer kind of edges. The shadows have a much more transparent kind of quality to them. They do a very different thing to our subjects. They can actually be excellent for traditional people-type shots and so on, but it's a totally different look from what we have with hard light. And again, certain types of subjects are going to benefit from it, certain types won't. And this is one of the things that good photographers do, is they train themselves to understand the effects of light and shadow and to take advantage of the opportunities that present themselves. Now, one thing to keep in mind, anytime you're shooting in bright sun with those dark, hard-edged shadows, understand that almost every time, the shadows are going to look darker in your camera than they did to your naked eye. And that's important. You can be photographing anything from a lawnmower that you're trying to sell online to a portrait to a landscape. And if you have important information that is in dark shadows, when you have that hard lighting, you may want to consider taking steps to lighten those shadows. That could be deliberately using your exposure compensation to lighten the whole picture, and we'll talk about that in a future lesson. Or consider, if you're near to the subject, consider using a flash or turning on your built-in flash to give a little bit of light to fill those shadows in so that those dark shadows now have some information. The important thing here, though, is to learn not only to see important, useful subjects or scenes, but to be able to see the light that's hitting those scenes and the shadows that they create.